Good evening, Candy Kids and families. Hope each of you are doing well, staying safe, and staying healthy. The Children's Ministry here at Canyon Baptist Church is continuing to be moving forward with Children's Church at 9 a.m. and Children's Journey Groups at 10:30. Make plans now to join us in the Children's Wing this Wednesday night for Wednesday's Gone Wacky as we continue learning about Bible drill together. Also, our Wednesday's Gone Wacky theme for the month of March is Come Dressed as Your Favorite Superhero. But before I share with you your Children's Church lesson, tonight, let's have a time of worship with one of our worship songs. Let's worship together with Happy Day. That's right. It's always a happy day when we ask Jesus in our heart, it gives us excitement. We need to go share that excitement with other believers and other people that don't know who Jesus is, because every day with Jesus is another happy day, because he gives another day to breathe, another day to live, and another day to sing his praises. So it's always a happy day. Well, tonight, I want to like to share with you your Children's Church lesson from Sunday, March 7th. So go ahead and find your Bible and turn in your Bible and look for the book of Acts. Acts is also located in the New Testament. We're looking at Acts chapter 8 and 9. Obviously, my Bible here is turned in Acts chapter 8 and Acts chapter 9. And we're talking about how Paul met Jesus. After Jesus died and rose from the dead and ascended to heaven, people in Jerusalem who believed in Jesus were persecuted or treated cruelly because of their faith in Jesus. One of Jesus' followers, Stephen, was even killed, and a man named Saul had watched in approval when Stephen was killed. Saul wanted to put it into the church, and he went into believers' homes and dragged them out and put them in jail, and many believers fled the city. Saul headed to Damascus to arrest believers that were there. But on the way, a bright light from heaven suddenly flashed around him. Saul fell to the ground. He heard a voice from the light saying, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" "Who are you, Lord?" Saul asked. Saul asked that question, and the light said, "I am Jesus," he replied. "Get up and go into the city, and there you will be told what you must do." So Saul got up and he opened his eyes, but when he opened his eyes, he could not see. So the men that were traveling with Saul led him by hand into Damascus. Aeneas, a disciple of Jesus, lived in the city of Damascus. And the Lord spoke to Aeneas in a vision, and he told Aeneas to go into the house where Saul was staying. Now here, Aeneas knew that Saul had hurt many believers, and that he arrested anyone who believed in Jesus. But the Lord told Aeneas and said, "Go, I have chosen this man to take my name to the Gentiles, kings, and Israelites." So Aeneas did what God commanded him to do and obeyed God. And so Aeneas went and he found Saul, and he told Saul that Jesus had sent him to help him. Aeneas put his hands on Saul, and Saul could see again. Saul got up and he was baptized. For the next few days, Saul stayed with the believers in Damascus. He even began to go to synagogues to preach about Jesus. Saul told the people, "Jesus is the Son of God." Saul shared the good news. And as Saul shared this news that Jesus is the Son of God, the people that are around were just amazed. They recognized Saul, and they knew he wanted to put it into the church. But guess what? Now Saul was one of them. The Jews, though, did not like Saul's message, and they planned to kill him. So one night, Saul left the city. The disciples helped Saul escape by lowering him down the city wall in a basket. Later on, Saul was also known as Paul. And Saul, even though he hated Christians, he persecuted Christians, he was ready to kill them and put them in jail and take them out of their homes. God changed Saul's heart. God changed his heart from the inside out, and he became a believer. He knew the importance of Jesus, knew what Jesus did for him in his life, and he wanted to share and let other people know who Jesus is. And he continued to share the good news, even when people were after him now for the same thing he was doing. So he continued to share the good news, and that's how Paul met Jesus, and Saul's name was turned into Paul. And so it just reminds me that even as Christians, that God changes the heart. And even though he changes our heart, we need to still go and tell others the good news of Jesus. Even though Jesus comes inside our heart, we don't stop sharing the good news. We continue to share the good news with others we come in contact with and share the love of Christ through our attitude, our actions, the words we say, the things we do, and the people we see. So we need to continue to do that. And that's what Paul was doing. He continued to share the good news of the gospel. His heart was changed inside out, and he wanted others to know the importance of that Jesus is the Son of God. And Paul continued to do that. And people didn't like what he was doing, and he still continued to share the good news. Well, every month we have a big picture question of the month. And our big picture question of the month is, why does the church exist? I hear some kids hollering out to the parents, or I said it to the parents, and I know they already know the answer. And we talked about why the church exists. Here's why the church exists. The church exists to glorify God by worshiping him, showing his love, and telling others about Jesus, just like Saul did. He glorified God by worshiping him, showing his love, and telling others about Jesus. That is why the church exists. The church exists to do those things, and that we're supposed to glorify God by worshiping, showing his love, and telling others about Jesus. Let's go and watch our video of today's lesson, how Paul met Jesus, from Acts chapter 8 and Acts chapter 9.
After Jesus died, rose from the dead, and ascended to heaven, people in Jerusalem who believed in Jesus were persecuted or treated cruelly because of their faith. One of Jesus' followers, Stephen, was even killed. A man named Saul had watched in approval when Stephen was killed. Saul wanted to put an end to the church. He went into the believers' homes, dragged them out, and put them in jail. Many believers fled the city. Saul headed to Damascus to arrest believers there, but on the way, a bright light from heaven suddenly flashed around him. Saul fell to the ground. He heard a voice saying, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" "Who are you, Lord?" Saul asked. "I am Jesus," he replied. "Get up and go into the city. Then you will be told what you must do." Saul got up and opened his eyes, but he couldn't see. So the men who were traveling with Saul led him by the hand into Damascus. Ananias, a disciple of Jesus, lived in Damascus. The Lord spoke to Ananias in a vision. He told Ananias to go to the house where Saul was staying. Ananias knew that Saul had hurt many believers and that he arrested anyone who believed in Jesus. But the Lord said, "Go, I have chosen this man to take my name to Gentiles, kings, and Israelites." Ananias obeyed. He found Saul and told Saul that Jesus had sent him to help. Ananias put his hands on Saul, and Saul could see again. Saul got up and was baptized. For the next few days, Saul stayed with the believers in Damascus. He began to go to the synagogues to preach about Jesus. Saul told the people, "Jesus is the Son of God." The people were amazed. They recognized Saul and knew he had wanted to put an end to the church. Now he was one of them. The Jews did not like Saul's message. They planned to kill him, so one night Saul left the city. The disciples helped Saul escape by lowering him down the city wall in a basket. Saul was also known as Paul. Jesus appeared to Saul and changed him inside and out. Jesus Christ came into the world to save sinners. Jesus called Paul, who was once an enemy to Christians, to spend the rest of his life telling people the gospel and leading them to trust in Jesus.
Amen. Let's have a time of prayer this evening. Dear Lord, we just thank you for this evening, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for our many Canaan kids and families, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for watching over them, protecting them, keeping them safe, Lord. Lord, we just ask you to be with our Canaan kids and watch over them as they go about their daily week and the rest of their week this week. Ask you to keep them safe and ask you to just keep them strong in their studies at school as they approach spring break and things coming up, Lord. Just ask you just to watch over each and every family, Lord. Continue to be with those in our Canaan family that are sick or hurting, Lord. Just ask you to be with them, be as a comforter to them, and just be that great position for them, Lord. Continue to watch over our pastor search team, Lord, as they continue to find the shepherd that you have to lead our flock, Lord. Just ask you to be with them during the process and watch over them and keep them safe and keep them all healthy, Lord. Continue to be with our country, Lord, and those that are in leadership, Lord, and continue to be with those that are make decisions, Lord, in our federal government, even our local government as well, Lord. Continue to be with those in Fultondale that are still affected by the tornado, Lord, and those that have been affected by other tornadoes or national disasters like the ice storm in Texas and Louisiana, Lord. Continue to be with those people recovering from those situations that happened these last couple of weeks, Lord. Continue to watch over each and every family. Keep us safe and looking forward to watching over us, having you watch over us during the weeks and the days ahead, Lord. Also, just be with us as we continue to study your word together, Lord, as we gather together on Sundays and Wednesdays. In your name we pray. Amen. Kenny, kids and families, I just hope you all have a great rest of your evening. Hope you guys all stay safe. Hope you guys all stay healthy. Hope to see you guys Wednesday night for Wednesday's Gone Wacky from 6 to 7 p.m. in the children's wing. And don't forget about our Wednesday's Gone Wacky theme night for the month of March is come dressed as your favorite superhero. Also, on Sunday, March 14th is a special Children's Church Sunday. We are going to have our preview of a Vacation Bible School Destination Dig. So go ahead and make plans to join us Sunday morning, 9 a.m. for Children's Church in the Children's Wing as we preview Vacation Bible School Destination Dig. Every child that is attendance in Children's Church will receive a special prize of Vacation Bible School goodies. So go ahead and make plans now to join us Sunday, March 14th, 9 a.m. here in the Children's Building. We're going to have a special preview of Destination Dig, our Vacation Bible School theme for this summer. So go ahead and make plans now to join us and receive your special prize from joining us on Sunday morning at 9 a.m. I just hope you guys all have a great rest of your week, and I'll see you guys soon. See you later.